today, 3 years after, we are now worldwide in our business, and some of our close friends or partners we have, they see us as a very one of the number one any scale part designing. And I have to say, all thanks to Shapr3D. My name is Osvaldo Correia, but known as Ozzy. I live in Canada, Ontario, and the district of Muskoka. And we work with RC planes, scale parts to design and 3D print them, actually manufacture them by 3D printers. Those RC jets actually is a huge hobby worldwide. The hobbyists, they take that very seriously. In fact, it's a very expensive hobby because it involves a lot of electronics. It involves like engines, like actually turbines. They actually are real turbines. And those planes can reach the speed around between 400 and 500 kilometers an hour, depending on the size or the type of the plane. And the design of those planes are really very, very scale. And people who manufacture them, they really take seriously the details they can put on those planes. You realize that despite the plane are very well built, it flies like a real plane, but some details in the plane was like a little bit poor in scale details, like for example, cockpits. For our experience that we hear from friends, they are very savvy with the quality of the cockpits inside the plane. So, okay, let's try to develop something. And that's how we start to develop the cockpit. In the beginning, when I start in the company, I'm graphic design for over 35 years, right? So when I live in Brazil, where I'm from, there I started a company making planes. So in 1997, I started this company. At that time, no technology at all. So basically, I designed the plane out on the CorelDRAW and cut everything manually in those little jigsaw, those machines, and make molds and use vacuum form technology. At that time, I had that. Still, I have here too. It's very helpful. And I started the company that time. So when I moved to Canada, I stayed away from graphic design for over 12 years. But when we planned to move out from big city to the country, that's when we started to have an idea. Well, maybe I start make planes again. Maybe I start paint planes. That's something I'm good too. But the 3D part just came by accident, because that's when I bought my small plane. That plane actually I want to take molds to make in fiberglass. And you see if eventually people have interest and buy it. But when I saw the cockpit, that's just turned my attention to that. I thought, oh, maybe I should make a new cockpit for this plane. That's how it started. And then I saw Shapr3D on Facebook right away about the iPad Pro, subscribe, Shapr3D, start to play. Took a little while to learn, probably maybe a month to start to make something nice. And that's it, and I never stopped. You know, Shapr3D. Basically, my process is, like, for example, the ejection seat I have today, the first one that we work, basically, all the details I got through Pinterest photos. So I used to put these photos in the workspace, and some of them, I scale them, I a little bit work on the shape, and try to look some graphs, like the blueprints and stuff. And then that's try to find the right scale for that seat to look everything properly. And that's it, because one issue we have, especially in Canada, probably in Europe, I know a lot of friends, they have much more easy access to military planes or parts. In Canada, no. Canada is almost impossible to go in a military base and ask, oh, can I take a picture of this ejection seat? No. Most you can go is museum. But museum, sometimes they don't have exactly what you're looking for, right? But you can maybe go there. Like I used to go in some of museums just to get some shapes of some stuff. Like, for example, we designed a section for one jet, the Italian jet, that NEB 339. The plane is 4 meters long. It's a huge jet, very popular in Europe, especially in Italy. So we developed a section, and inside the fuselage, they have a hydraulic section. So that hydraulic section is a bunch of pipes in so many different shapes for permanent, and they connect with their proper parts they have to. I don't even know how that functions in real life. But through photos, I try to figure out, okay, this is going like that, I connect here, and just amazing design. And I use all the tools Shapr3D has, Sweep, Revolve, all those tools that allowed you to do this. No, you do the line, do the circle, do the shape you want of the line and make that sweep, whatever you want to go. So I have this amazing, probably I have to say maybe it's the best design we have in our website in complexity. So I have farm labs, right? I have three farm labs, but because farm labs that I have is limit in size. So we bought 3D system, 2500 plus. Is that it can print in large format. So we use the machine more for jigs or to make plugs for molds. So our process, for example, for large parts, like for the box where I go the hydraulics, for example, we print one part and from that part, so using the 3D system, and from that we make a mold and or either recasting or making a part in fiberglass or epoxy, right? And in the case of the ejection seat, the size of the seats, the back, the bottom, they all custom. And the CNC, still we are very new on that. We designed a plane. It's a very large plane, but it's not a jet. It's a special order for one of our partners. This plane is going to be about almost 4 meters long. So we designed this plane all on the Shapr3D. To us, it's an innovation for us because you see a lot of other companies, they use other softwares to design planes. We want to make sure we can do that and show people that we can do that in Shapr3D. And then we can. I saw the design is done. We now just learn to operate the CNC machine. So, and then we're going to start to make the plug and go from there. But yeah, well, everything is designed, the fuselage, the wings, the elevators, everything is designed right to make the plugs. Right? Today, 3 years after, we are now worldwide in our business. And some of our close friends or partners we have, they see us as a very, one of the number one any scale pipe designing. And I have to say, all thanks to Shapr3D. And today, I very proudly, I can say, I use Shapr3D 100% for all our designs. Now, you don't use any other tool. This is all made with Shapr3D. And I'm very thankful for Shapr3D came up with this amazing features, because I think that's the future, that feature they fit it all. So basically that's what it is.